What is up, guys, and welcome back to the Johnny Q channel. Thanks so much for watching. Today's episode is all about drones. This guy, the DJI Mavic Air. I almost said Mavic Pro. So before we get into the Mavic Air and why I love it so much and why you should get it, let me show you some beautiful Mavic Air footage. Cue that intro video. Now what I want to do is actually bring the drone home. So instead of landing it by myself, this is what I can do. I'll take my gloves off, come down to the app here. I'll go to little H, I'll slide over. RTH stands for return to home. If your drone's way out in the boonies and you can't see it or get it, RTH button and it'll return home. So as you can probably hear, it's coming down by itself. And all I have to do is just wait for it to come down. And boom, just like that, it's returned home. Let's just touch on the fact that you can get aerial footage from this thing in 4K. Like what you just saw was 4K at 24 frames a second. That is crazy insane. I remember like 5-6 years ago, you'd have to get a helicopter. You'd have to get your friend's giant white drones, those big phantom ones, and those cost thousands of dollars. But any Joe can go out to a Best Buy or wherever they sell drones and get this for like $700-something. That is just crazy to me. Let me show you how it folds up and goes back neatly into its case. It's very, very, very well thought out, and I dig that so much. Thank you, DJI. Let's go over kind of the parts of what makes this drone. I don't know if you can see here, but there's little standing legs right here. These fold up and down. So when you're on the surface, you're not actually putting your drone on snowy surface. So the camera and the gimbal don't get touched, don't get hurt. Actually goes to show you that DJI made, you know, really good decisions while it made this drone. Like it was well thought out for the consumer. Here, if I flip this little thing open, I don't know if you can see it. Some sort of micro USB connection. Then there's the micro SD card. It's kind of a hassle to take out. I've thought about breaking this little piece off so I don't have to deal with it, but not there yet. Another thing that I love about this drone is the thought and intentionality about the battery. Now this is the battery. It just lives under the drone here, this little cartridge, and you pull it out. And this is the size of the battery. But the battery though, it's very compact. I will say I can only get about 13 to 15 minutes out of every flight. Now today was different because it's so freaking cold out. Speaking of which, my hands are very cold. Gloves on. I'm gonna put my gloves on because it honestly gave me 3 minutes of flight time. And so I was like, oh my gosh, I gotta get the shots that I wanna get. So I kinda just flew it in sport mode. We'll get to that in a little bit. But the battery, what you can do to check, you know, the battery and how much juice it has is this. This is off. If I just press this button once, it shows me, it blinks once or twice or three or four times depending on how fully juiced this is. Now, if it was fully juiced, it would light up all the little green circles, but this is just on one little green circle, which means, yo, you gotta charge me. It's a simple, just put it in snap, and if you hear the snap, it's in there. So this is drone without battery. This is the battery. Line it up, and then you just align it and click. DJI figured that, you know, there's gonna be some fools out there like me that just fly the drone, don't really know how to fly it, and they're gonna crash like me. And as you can see here, the propellers, yeah, they're a little broken, a little chipped off, a little scraped. So what DJI did is they include more propellers in the packaging, which is amazing. I think there's two more pairs of each, so I would say a total of 8, which I should go home and actually switch these old ones to the new ones, which I will, I promise. Thinking, yo, bro, how does it actually fold up and go into that little case you had? How does it do that? Well, It's actually quite simple. And you have to fold this drone in a certain way or else it really doesn't work and it's not as intuitive. So kick those little stands down, bring them down and fold them in. Bring them down and fold them in. Keep the propellers parallel to the drone. They go under, under. And you wanna make sure these propellers are parallel to the drone, and voila, you have a small compact drone. That is simply amazing. It really is. The design of this, the intuitiveness, the sleek, it speaks to me because I'm all about this compact. You know, I've got a big bag full of camera gear, lenses, all the stuff, and I just don't want to carry a big old drone. Like, I want something compact like this. To turn the drone on is simple. You go down to this little button by the battery, press twice. On the second press, you hold, and it'll beep and make all these noise. I will show you right now. And to turn it off, same thing. Press twice, on the second press, you hold. Now, okay, let's move on to the controller. If you have an iPhone, this works perfectly because it has an actual iPhone jack that you can just plug in, and that just works perfectly with your phone and the app and the remote. Same thing with this. If you wanna turn this on, there's a little power button right up here. You press it twice, and does a little ding-a-ling sound. Ding-a-ling, that's a weird thing to say. This thing is compact as well. Like, the way I just folded it up, I mean, it's so small, look at this. The cool thing about these steering wheels is this. Let me take off my... You're like, oh man, I wish these little steering pegs or wheels just weren't on here so I can put it in my bag. Dude, this is awesome. You can just take it, unscrew it, and put it underneath. Like, there's a little cubby, a little port for your little guys or your little wheels or pegs right here. So here we go again. Unscrew it, and boom. Just right in there. And guess what? Fold that up neatly just like this. Fold these little antenna and boom. Look at that. That is compact. That is what I'm talking about. That, like, the fact that I can just make it so compact, make it fit into my backpack, and then just whip it out and be like, boom, drone footage. That is so legit to me. I love it. To turn this off, you press twice. On the second press, you hold, it turns it off. Boom. Gloves again. There is a home button, like I said, that, you know, returning back to home, RTH, you can return your drone back to home by either pressing on the button on your screen and sliding it over, or just pressing this button. It works two ways. And the sport mode on here, I don't know if you can see it right there. Let me zoom, hold on. If you can see it right here, this is sport. Sport mode. Not sport mode, sport mode. Not sport mode, sport mode. And let me tell you, the sport mode on this thing, don't be fooled by its size. Don't be fooled by this little guy. I'm about to go in. Instead of doing it, just going, it goes, bro, I'm about to go in. It just hyperspeed, like Star Wars hyperspeed crap. That's some good speed. Thank you, DJI. One other thing I love about this controller is that you can switch from video to photo very easily. You don't have to go in and out of your app, and you don't have to interrupt your flight at all. You just, if you're in video mode, just like right here, this little red button, and you wanna go to photo mode, mid-air, all you have to do is click photo mode and it goes to photo mode on the drone. And I mean, not to mention, like, look at this case. It is beautifully designed. It's kind of like a hard, soft case. It's in between. I love it all. So if you're looking for that drone, you're looking for kind of, you know, what do I get that's not super expensive that I can use, that shoots really good quality, that gives me what I want, and, but, you know, I could get potential work from it, the DJI Mavic Air is the way to go. So with that being said, I will catch you next time on the Johnny Q channel. Peace. We'll be right back.